The powerful Raptor 3, considered the centerpiece of SpaceX's upcoming flight technology, this newly developed engine has delivered impressive test results, demonstrating significant improvements in thrust, efficiency, and reliability. The Raptor 3 represents a significant advancement in rocket technology, paving the way for a new era of enhanced reusability. So, how much power does it have, and what updates has SpaceX made? Let's discuss it all in today's episode of NR Studio. It's been just a few days since Flight 11, the final mission of Starship V2. This momentous flight not only marked the end of one phase, but also the beginning of a new stage in SpaceX's quest to achieve full reusability and interplanetary exploration. The transition to V3 brought a comprehensive set of key upgrades, among them the Raptor 3 engine, considered one of the most anticipated innovations. During the live stream of Flight 11, SpaceX provided an impressive preview of this next-generation engine in action. In the short 27-second clip, the company showcased two different tests, one for the sea-level variant and another for its vacuum variant. Despite its short duration, the test demonstrated the incredible power and advanced engineering that are the hallmarks of the Raptor 3. The sea-level engine was the first to be showcased. As the engine fired, spectators could observe frost accumulating near the top of the engine, an effect enhanced by its sleek black surface and streamlined design. This stunning visual not only captivated the eye, but also illustrated the engine's effectiveness in handling cryogenic fuel. Under frost, the Raptor 3 produced an incredible 280 tons of thrust. This marked a substantial advance, surpassing the capabilities of Blue Origin's BE-4 engine, once considered a formidable competitor in the Methalox category. The Raptor 3 demonstration also highlighted improvements to its gimbal functionality. The engine appeared to be mounted on a setup similar to the Starship engine bay, allowing it to rotate freely during operation. This mobility allows the engine to continuously adjust its trajectory without sacrificing thrust, which is crucial for precise flight control. These movements will be crucial throughout various phases of flight, including liftoff, orbital insertion, payload deployment, and controlled re-entry. In the future, this level of precision will be crucial for complex maneuvers like in-orbit refueling or navigating through deep space. After completing sea-level tests, SpaceX launched its Raptor vacuum engine, a variant engineered for use in the vacuum of space. This was likely the first public demonstration of a Raptor vacuum test, and it was certainly successful. During its brief operation, the engine achieved over 300 tons of thrust, peaking at 306 tons, making it the most powerful liquid-fueled engine of its kind to date. While it cannot gimbal, the elongated nozzle design increases its effectiveness in a vacuum, enabling it to provide continuous power in conditions lacking atmospheric pressure. In contrast to the engines optimized for sea level, which prioritize adaptability and control, the vacuum variant concentrates solely on maximizing performance. Together, they create a synergistic duo that will propel Starship into its next developmental phase. These trials, even if brief, have already sparked significant enthusiasm for the forthcoming V3 launch. It is important to mention that the video released by SpaceX only showcases brief clips of each trial. In actuality, each engine test may extend for several minutes, testing the systems under intense pressure and temperature conditions. Nonetheless, the true evaluation of Raptor 3's abilities will occur during an official flight. Only in the context of a complete launch will these engines endure the combined challenges of heat, vibration, and aerodynamic forces while operating together. The upcoming static fire test of booster S-39, slated to occur shortly, will mark a vital milestone toward that objective. The succeeding flight, labeled Starship Flight 12, will hold even greater significance as it will examine not only Raptor 3's effectiveness, but also its durability during the re-entry phase. There are numerous hurdles ahead, yet SpaceX has ample reason for optimism. The firm has made remarkable advancements with Raptor 3 in terms of both performance and construct. The most apparent enhancement is in thrust capability. The sea-level model has risen from 230 tons in Raptor 2 to 280 tons, while the vacuum model has achieved 306 tons. This positions Raptor 3 as the most potent Methalox engine developed to date and ranks it among the most formidable liquid-fueled engines globally. This breakthrough essentially puts SpaceX ahead of its nearest rivals. Previously, the BE-4 engine from Blue Origin, with its 250-ton thrust, provided the company with a slight edge in engine performance. That advantage no longer exists. With Raptor 3, SpaceX has regained the lead, establishing a new standard for rocket propulsion technology. Furthermore, the sheer strength of Starship's design is not solely due to the enhanced thrust from each engine, but rather how all 33 engines on the Super Heavy booster collaborate. Collectively, they generate over 9,000 tons of thrust at launch, which is roughly 2.7 times more than the iconic Saturn V rocket that transported astronauts to the moon. Nevertheless, this is merely the initial phase. Based on Musk's insights and the latest technical reports, SpaceX aims to exceed 10,000 tons of total thrust with subsequent versions, starting with Starship V4. To accomplish this, each engine must yield approximately 330 tons of thrust, advancing the boundaries of rocket engineering even more. Raptor 3 also powers the Starship vehicle, producing over 1,700 tons of total thrust across its configuration.
This substantial capability will be crucial for upcoming missions to the Moon, Mars, and possibly further locations. A primary enhancement of Raptor 3 is its more straightforward construction. This iteration was designed to lower complexity by removing smaller components prone to failure and substituting them with larger, more cohesive systems. Previously problematic bolted joints and screws, which could lead to leaks or heat buildup, have been replaced with welded connections. This adjustment not only boosts reliability, but also decreases weight, an essential element for efficiency. The weight reduction is noteworthy. Raptor 3 now has a mass of around 1,525 kilograms compared to 1,600 kilograms for Raptor 2 and nearly 2,000 kilograms for the original version. While it has shed weight, it is significantly more powerful and resilient. Another major advancement is the incorporation of an active cooling mechanism, which ensures the engine functions reliably under high temperatures and pressures. As a result, Raptor 3 no longer needs an external heat protection system, which removes unnecessary bulk. The weight that was saved can now increase the payload limit, allowing Starship version 3 to transport over 100 tons into orbit, which is a considerable increase from its predecessor. This advancement also enabled SpaceX to eliminate one of the heaviest elements from the prior version, the external heat shield. This shield was initially created to prevent thermal damage to the engine, yet it contributed significant weight. Thanks to the new active cooling system, that extra shield is no longer required. Its removal not only cuts down weight, but also enhances overall flight efficiency. However, the benefits of Raptor 3's more straightforward design reach far beyond just performance and flight metrics. Its impact is evident in every phase of SpaceX's operations, starting with manufacturing. Simplicity plays a vital role in scaling production, and SpaceX has already shown how this approach propels advancement. When moving from Raptor 1 to Raptor 2, the company shortened the manufacturing timeline from over 11 days per engine to just 2, and eventually down to a single day. Raptor 3 enhances this trend with an even neater and more cohesive design that removes unnecessary elements and streamlines assembly. SpaceX is making swift progress on Raptor 3 production through automation and modern methods such as precision welding, robotics, and large-scale 3D printing, leading to quicker, more reliable, and cost-effective production. The simplified approach reduces costs and enhances reliability, facilitating genuine, rapid reusability. In contrast to Raptor 2, which required significant maintenance, Raptor 3's efficient build allows for quick checks and immediate relaunch. Musk imagines Super Heavy boosters taking flights every hour and Starships operating daily, a target made achievable by the efficiency of this engine.
Despite its revolutionary advances, the Raptor 3 faces its own set of challenges. The staged combustion process that increases its efficiency is also extremely complex. This system requires meticulous accuracy at every stage, as even small differences in fuel flow or combustion can lead to catastrophic failure. The benefits of superior efficiency, improved cooling, and increased performance with cryogenic fuels come with the challenge of extreme engineering complexity. every pump, valve, and chamber must function in perfect harmony. Furthermore, achieving simplicity often involves compromises. To create cleaner and lighter designs, SpaceX is increasingly relying on the combination of smaller elements and the use of advanced welding methods rather than conventional bolts and flanges. While this approach improves performance and reduces weight, it adds complexity when repairs are needed. If a problem occurs within the engine, it may not be easy to remove the part for assessment or replacement. Technicians may need to cut the engine casing itself, a time-consuming and potentially dangerous process. For a company seeking rapid reusability and turnaround times measured in hours, this can be a significant challenge if not effectively addressed. Nonetheless, these difficulties are integral to the natural progression of innovative technology. Each version of the Raptor has provided valuable lessons. Each engine serves as a foundation toward the ultimate goal of reliable, cost-effective, and frequent space travel. SpaceX is now on the verge of significant change. The upcoming Starship V3, powered by Raptor 3, is more than just an upgrade. It marks the beginning of a new chapter in propulsion, reliability, and capability. The upcoming flight, Starship Flight 12, will be the first to showcase this upgraded engine in real-world conditions. Whether it occurs in December or early next year, this will be a pivotal moment for the program. Achieving success will validate years of refinement and risk-taking, potentially facilitating rapid reusability and expanding payload capacity to uncharted levels. With Raptor 3, SpaceX aims to do more than simply improve the rocket. They are seeking to reshape the future of interplanetary exploration. And when the first V3 vehicle takes flight, the world will witness an extraordinary level of human engineering where ambition meets relentless innovation. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.